Here is the quote that's used throughout the literature. Are you ready? I think you actually use this in one of your papers.
Maybe.
The learning curve for reading these MRIs is steep and long. Let me repeat that. The learning curve is steep and long. So before you answer, not only does that make sense to me, it makes me think, why in the HE double toothpicks am I going to have someone read it that doesn't read a ton of these things? This, you know, we argue all day long. A surgeon's got to do so many radicals. A radiation oncologist has got to do so many radiation treatments to be considered an expert. A pathologist has to read so many slides to be an expert. Why aren't we arguing this about the radiologist and MRIs? What am I missing?
No, that's exactly the right question to ask. So when you are looking for a surgeon, you don't simply say, do you do surgery? Right? You want to know how much prostate surgery do you do?
Right.
Right. And there are some really good surgeons that do kidney stones and do some prostates and some bladders and, you know, the full gamut. And probably a skilled surgeon would do a adequate job. But you want to optimize the likelihood that you will get a good surgeon. So you want her or him to have done a number of prostate surgeries, and ideally with the latest technology, so robotic or laparoscopic or whatever technique they're planning to use, and to specialize in prostate surgery so that they're not doing stones all day long every day. And at most larger institutions, they have some of the urologists that do primarily prostate. And then they have other urologists for things like female pelvic floor disorders and kidneys and kidney stones and other things. Similarly, there are a number of radiology groups where everybody reads everything. I was that guy for a year and a half. And I was better at some things than others. But this is when we weren't doing prostate MR. Now, I will mention that I did not do procedures because that is, those stakes are high enough that you want somebody that's focused on that.
Okay.
And while I did read mammograms, they were deciding whether or not I should continue. So I was fresh out of training. I was trained to read mammograms, but only a small number of the radiologists read mammograms because you have to, legally have to, only read you have to read a certain number every year. And what we are planning to do for prostate MRI is the site accreditation for excellence in body MRI will have a component for prostate MRI that will look at the quality of the scan. So these sites will have to supply a certain number of clinical studies that have been de-identified or anonymized, but also show that their radiologists have read a certain number of prostate MRI scans. And for a lot of the radiologists coming out of fellowship training, if they specialize in abdominal and pelvic imaging, you know, as I was saying, we do somewhere between 2 and 5 prostate MRs a day. So if you do that for a few months, you've seen a lot of prostate MR. And you're training with people that only read abdominal pelvic MR. And so you're training with people that are specialized in it. And so the good news is if you find somebody who's fellowship trained and focused in it, that person is probably adequately trained. And the American College of Radiology has done a very good job of providing training for radiologists, not only nationwide, but even for radiologists from, we've had patients or students rather from Columbia, the country of Columbia, not my fellow campus to the north, and Australia, and they have a program where they read 150 prostate MRs in a day and a half, which is a very grueling day and a half. And at that point, they're more or less ready. And then by the time they've read, you know, a couple dozen more, they're good to go. So it's important to ask, the person that will read the prostate MRI, how many scans has she read?
Yeah.
And how many does she read in a week?
Yeah. And what's the answer I want besides, if it's zero, of course, I'm running for the hills.
Right.
What am I looking for in terms of some kind of clarity that this person is somewhat competent?
At least 200 scans in her lifetime.
In lifetime.
Yeah, and ideally 500, but 200 is generally enough if they're focused in that area. And you want them to be reading at least two or three a week. Because at a lot of sites, that's about the volume that they get.
Yeah.
And for those of us that focus on abdominal and pelvic imaging, that's about what we do.
So let's say I don't get that. And I go, I mean, I'm entitled to that information, right? So a lot of people watching this right now have thought, I didn't think to ask that. Or if I get one of these, I didn't think to ask. It's perfectly logical. Can you please tell people that are watching to ask that question before you proceed?
Yes. Your radiologist is a medical specialist, just like your surgeon and your medical oncologist. And she or he should be trained in what they're doing. Yeah. So like I don't read mammograms anymore because I haven't read them in a long time and I don't trust myself to read mammograms. And I shouldn't. So at most groups that do prostate imaging, they will pick a small number of their radiologists to focus on that. Whereas there's a lot of things that are so common and so straightforward, like a CT scan to rule out appendicitis or to look for a stroke. Those we do dozens a day. And so everybody has read tons of those and is not going to miss a significant finding.
Right. It's like acute diverticulitis, right? I could pinpoint that with my finger. And that's probably the only thing I could pinpoint on one of those scans. I mean,
I would press you to, yes. But prostate MRI, you need to leave it to the experts.
That is really makes my day that you gave us an actual quantifiable number that people can work with. Ideally, 200 scans would be nice. 500 ideally, 2 to 3 a week. I wrote those down.